हेलो फ्रेंड्स, दिस इज क्वेश्चन नंबर सी 3.3.3। लेट अस फर्स्ट रीड द क्वेश्चन। फ्रॉम द फॉलोइंग इन्फॉर्मेशन रिलेट्स टू एकेसी लिमिटेड विच मैन्युफैक्चर्स सम पार्ट ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉनिक डिवाइसेस विच आर एक्सपोर्टेड टू यूएसए, जापान एंड यूरोप ऑन 90 डेज क्रेडिट टर्म्स। सो प्रैक्टिकली यू आर एक्सपोर्टर। Variable cost per unit for the goods which are sold to Japan is given. Export sale price per unit is given. Receipt from sale due in 90 days in yen, dollars and euro is given. Foreign exchange rate. Now, we are in India. And see the rates, how they are given. Yen per rupees. We want rate of rupees per yen. What rate is given is yen per rupees. US dollar per rupees. We want rupees per dollar. The all indirect quotes are given. Is it all right? We know how to convert indirect quote into direct quote. But I'll explain you one time and then we'll be automatically taking it. Advise AKC Limited by calculating average contribution to sales ratio. Contribution to sales ratio is also known as PV ratio. Should it hedge its foreign currency risk or not? So, for contribution to sales ratio, I'll require, say, for Japan, for America, and for Europe. Let me first find out sales. Sales in yen is 78 lakhs yen. It is yen. 78 lakhs yen. I want to convert it into rupees. Which rate is required? This is receivable after 3 months. I will be using 3 months forward. Is it all right? If it is hedge, I will be using 3 months forward. Yes. Is it all right? So 78 lakhs yen. Is it all right? One time I am explaining, then we will be directly taking it. If the yen is receivable, we use a bid rate. But the rate should be rupees per yen. What rate is given is yen per rupees. So I need to convert it into a direct quote. It is an indirect quote. How I will convert it into indirect quote is 1 divided by 1 divided by. Bid will become ask 2.417. Ask will become bid 2.437. This is a direct quote of 3 months forward of rupees per yen. Yes. It is 2.427. This is 427. And 2.397. I used probably, yes. I used the spot rate. I am finding out 3 months forward rate. 1 divided by 2.427? Yes. 1 divided by 2.397? Yes. Now, if I am selling dollars, which rate will be used? The lower rate will be used. So, 2.427 rate will be used. Is it all right? Divided by 2.427, I will be getting answer in rupees. 78 lakhs divided by 2.427. It is 32,13,844. 32,13,844. Similarly, let me find out of even dollars and euro. Dollar is 1,02,300 divided by. Now I'm doing it in mind. Is it? I want a bid rate. What is ask in indirect is 0.0216. It will become bid when we do reciprocal 0.0216. So the answer will be 1,02,300 divided by 0.0216. It is 47,36,111. In euro, 95,920 is receivable. Which rate again I'll be using is bid rate for a direct quote. So ask rate for an indirect quote. It is 0.0178. I will be getting answer of 53,88,764. Let me also find out my variable cost. How to find out my variable cost is units. How to find out units is 78,00,000 yen. Divided by 650, so they are 12,000 units into 225, so it will be 27,00,000 rupees. Variable cost is rupees 27,00,000. Variable cost in this case, I am selling total $1,02,300 at the rate of rupees 20.23, it is 10,000 units. Into 395 will be 39,50,000 rupees. I'm first finding out number of units and then directly variable cost. 95,920 euro divided by 11.99 per unit multiplied by it is 8,000 units into 510 gives me 40,80,000 rupees. I can find out contribution. Right. In all the cases, 32,13,844 minus 27,00,000. It is 5,13,844. In this case, it will be 47,36,111 minus 39,50,000. It is 7,86,111, and this is 53,88,764 minus 40,80,000 gives me 1,13,8,764 rupees. Now, they are not asking me individually, so I am finding out one common PV ratio. What is total sales? 27,00,000 plus 39.5 lakhs plus 40.8 lakhs is 107,30,000. Is total sales? I'll be also finding out total variable cost. 5,13,844 plus 7,86,111 plus 13,08,764. It is a 26,08,719, and this will be total contribution. Total contribution will be minus 107,30,000. It is 81,21,281. The domestic variable cost is all right. Receipt is 32,13,047,00,000. I found a total variable cost. This is total variable cost. This is total contribution. This is total variable cost. This will be total sales. 107.30 plus 26,08,719. It is 133 lakhs. 38,719. Let us find out contribution to sales ratio. It is 81 lakh. Contribution to sales ratio. It is 81,21,281 divided by 133,38,719 is 26,08,789 divided by total sales 1,33,00,000. Yes, and the contribution answer will be 19.56%. This is if you hedge your risk. If you do not hedge your risk, your sales will differ. This answer is if you do not hedge. Know which rate you will be using? You will be using spot after 3 months. No. If you don't hedge, you will have to wait up till 3 months to decide what will be realized. What will be realized after 3 months is a 2.459, 0.2156, 0.179. And we can find out directly receipt. It is 31,72,021. Second is 47,44,898. Third one is 53,58,659. Are you getting it? How I have found out? It is number of units sold multiplied by spot after 3 months. Is it all right? So we will be taking which rate, ask rate given, and we will be dividing this figure by that figure. Let me explain you. It will be 78 lakhs yen divided by 2.459 will be this figure. 1,02,300 divided by 0.02156 will be this figure. 95,920 divided by 0.0179 will be this figure. And I will be getting total sales, which is 1,32,75,578. Variable cost remains same. 1,07,30,000. What will be my contribution is the difference. 1,32,75,578 minus 1,07,30,000 is 25,45,578. Contribution to sales ratio will 25,45,578 divided by sales is 1,32,75,578. This comes to 19.17%. Now try to understand. I have found out contribution to sales ratio if I hedge my risk, contribution to sales ratio if my expectations of the rates is correct, and all the rates given 3 months spot, my forecasting is correct, then my contribution to sales ratio will be only 19.17%, that is PV ratio will be 19.17%. If I hedge the risk, the PV ratio will be 19.56%. Based upon PV ratio, I should hedge my risk, because their PV ratio is increasing as compared to the spot of 3 months, which are already given in the question. Thank you, friends.